This is Stephen Smith, CAD/CAM consultant at Maya. Additive manufacturing provides some unique opportunities to identify components directly within the additive process. We can either look to add unique serial numbers or part numbers to components. So what I'll do here is just walk us through the process of creating a identification. So I'm just going to go ahead and click on the text icon here. We're going to put the text on a face. The face that we want is a single face. We'll just put it over here. And we'll go ahead and just give us a guide curve. So now what I'll do is I'll give this a text what we want it to write. So in this case, let's say I'm just going to put 00123. We can choose a variety of different fonts depending if there's a specific requirement. So in this case, let's just go ahead and use Times New Roman because we can. I'll look at some of our dimensions. So obviously this is a little bit too large for the face I've selected. So let's go ahead and put this in 4 millimeter height. The W scaling, I'm just going to throw this at 100%. And then I don't really want it right on this edge, so I can just go ahead and drag it up to move it. You can also offset a specific number here if you know what it's going to be. Because this is a print mark, we need to go ahead and check this box here, create print mark, and then we're going to define the thickness of the print marks. In this case, we'll just leave it to 1 millimeter, nice standard default. Go ahead and hit OK. So within the modeling environment, we see this is a new feature that's been added to the tree. What I've done ahead of time is I've just brought this component in twice to a simple additive file. Just go ahead and hit synchronize. We now see that we've brought in our print marks. If I'm happy with this, I can just go ahead and hit generate. And now we see that 1 millimeter setting that we previously had. What I can also do here, we can rename this. So let's say it's a unique serial number. I'm just going to go ahead and put in 12345. And then this is how we would set up unique serial numbers if that was the objective. There are methods to automate this. If let's say you had brought in 30 components, we can go ahead and pull the serial numbers from an Excel sheet, for example. So we'd be happy to help you with setting that up. This concludes our short video on creating print marks. Thank you for watching.